served as the director. This movie had a low budget of $7 million, and in my opinion was supposed to be one of those films that is only made to boost the ego of a clown who now wants to be taken seriously by making his own movie and playing the main character. Rust is a Western film set in the 1880s, focusing on themes of survival, justice, and redemption, as it always seems to be the case with Western movies. The story follows Harland Rust, an outlaw who comes out of hiding after learning that his 13-year-old grandson, Lucas, has been sentenced to hang for an accidental murder. Oh, the irony. Rust embarks on a dangerous journey across the American frontier to rescue Lucas, battling lawmen and bounty hunters along the way. Little did Baldwin know when writing this movie that his fate isn't gonna be much different from the fictional character he was making up. The film delves into the complexities of family, the harsh realities of the old West, and the length one will go to protect loved ones. But first, before we get into the accident, for those of us who don't really know who Alec Baldwin is, here's a little background information about him. Alec Baldwin, A-L-E-C-B-A-L-D-W-I-N, is a 66-year-old American actor, comedian, and producer. He was born in Amityville, New York, and rose to fame in the 1980s. His career started in television and had a breakthrough role in the movie Beetlejuice. He has earned several awards, including 2 Primetime Emmy Awards, 3 Golden Globe Awards, and 7 Screen Actors Guild Awards. Beyond his acting career, Baldwin has been an active political and social activist, which is the least attractive thing that an actor can do. He is an outspoken advocate for several causes, particularly environmental issues, animal rights, and, you guessed it, gun control. He has also been involved with PETA, which is the weirdest organization in the world. Baldwin's personal life has also been the subject of media attention. He has been married twice. First to actress Kim Basinger, B-A-S-I-N-G-E-R, with whom he has a daughter, accidentally shooting his cinematographer might be his last, and an end to his long, long career in Hollywood. It was in the morning of October 21st, 2021, when the Rust crew began filming at Bonanza Creek Ranch in Santa Fe, New Mexico. The day's schedule included rehearsing a scene inside a church set, where actor Alec Baldwin, who plays the lead role of Harland Rust, was required to use a revolver. At around 1:50 p.m., Baldwin was handed a Colt 45 revolver by assistant director Dave Halls, who declared it a Colt gun, indicating it is safe to use. Halls had received the gun from the film's armorer, Hannah Gutierrez Reed. During the rehearsal, Baldwin practiced drawing and pointing the revolver at the camera. The gun unexpectedly discharged, firing a live round that struck the cinematographer Helena Hutchins in the chest, and director Joel Souza, who was standing behind her, in the shoulder. Hutchins was airlifted to the University of New Mexico Hospital in Albuquerque, where she was pronounced dead. Souza was treated at a local hospital and later released. The Santa Fe County Sheriff's Office began investigating the incident. Baldwin was questioned and later released without charges. Then authorities issued a search warrant to seize the gun used in the shooting, along with other prop guns, ammunition, and cameras that might have recorded the incident. Baldwin, Gutierrez Reed, and other crew members provided statements to law enforcement. Baldwin expressed deep sorrow over the incident in public statements, calling it a tragic accident. In November of the same year, 2021, first lawsuit was filed. Script supervisor Mammy Mitchell filed the first civil lawsuit against Alec Baldwin, the producers, and other crew members, alleging negligence and dangerous working conditions. Several other crew members, including the gaffer Serge Svetnoy, also filed lawsuits claiming emotional distress and unsafe conditions on set. On December 2nd, in an interview with ABC News, Alec Baldwin claimed he did not pull the trigger on the gun and that it went off accidentally. He also stated that he was unaware the gun contained a live round and insisted that he trusted the professionals responsible for the weapons on set. Hannah Gutierrez Reed, through her attorneys, suggested that the incident may have been a case of sabotage, though this theory is not supported by evidence. In January of 2022, a search warrant for Baldwin's phone was issued. To obtain any communications related to the Rust production, including emails, texts, and phone calls. The Santa Fe County Sheriff's Office continued to investigate how live ammunition ended up on the set, focusing on the roles of the armorer, assistant director, and other crew members. Next month in February, Helena Hutchins' family filed a wrongful death lawsuit against Baldwin, the producers, and others involved in the production. The lawsuit alleged that Baldwin and the production team were negligent in maintaining safety on set, which led to Hutchins' death. In October of 2022, the Hutchins family reached a settlement in their wrongful death lawsuit. As part of the settlement, Matthew Hutchins, Helena's widower, is named an executive producer on the film, and the settlement included a plan to resume the production of Rust in 2023 with enhanced safety protocols. Yes, the movie was still made. It's not out though. I don't know if it ever will be. Now it's January 2023. The Santa Fe District Attorney announced that Alec Baldwin and armorer Hannah Gutierrez Reed will be charged with involuntary manslaughter. The charge carries a potential sentence of up to 18 months in prison. Assistant Director Dave Halls signed a plea agreement for negligent use of a deadly weapon. He was the one who handed Baldwin the gun. Baldwin's attorneys argued that the charges against Alec Baldwin were unwarranted and that Baldwin was relying on the professionals on set to ensure the safety of the weapon. Baldwin and Gutierrez Reed made their first court appearance via video conference and both pleaded not guilty to the charges in February of 2023. In April of 2023, prosecutors dropped the involuntary manslaughter charges against Alec Baldwin, citing new evidence that suggests the gun might have been modified in a way that made it more likely to fire without the trigger being pulled. That's awful. Then why did they put live ammunition inside it? The case against Gutierrez Reed continued, and prosecutors left open the possibility of refiling charges against Baldwin if further evidence warranted it. The Santa Fe District Attorney's Office continues to investigate into the incident. focusing on the actions of the armorer and other crew members. Hannah Gutierrez Reed's legal team continues to fight the involuntary manslaughter charge, arguing that she was not responsible for the presence of live ammunition on the set. Now let's talk about the armorer. Hannah Gutierrez Reed was born in 1997, and she is the daughter of Thel Reed, Thellreed. A veteran Hollywood armorer and weapons expert. At the time of the incident, she was only 24. Hannah's responsibility as the armorer included managing and maintaining firearms, providing firearms to actors, overseeing ammunition, training and safety briefings, and working with the prop master. Following the fatal incident on the set of Rust, questions arose about Hannah's experience and qualifications for the role. It was reported that Rust was only her second job as an armorer, and concerns had been raised previously about her inexperience. Investigations into the incident revealed potential lapses in safety protocols on set, including reports that live ammunition was found mixed with dummy rounds and blanks. In conclusion, a lot of failures led to the tragic death of Helena Hutchins, the 42-year-old mother. Her son, Andros, was only 9 years old when she passed. Now I turn the question over to you. Who do you believe is to blame for this tragic incident? Should it be the responsibility of the armorer, the actor, the production team, or perhaps a combination of all? And what charges, if any, you think should be brought against those involved in this shooting? Let me know your thoughts.